Plaza increases it up to $10,000. routes is the Southeast High Speed Rail Corridor. And the Amtrak routes have been increasing at the same time as having the Metabus operation.
That's good news.
Great news.
Great.
Any questions?
Make a motion for the council to approve.
And we have a public hearing.
All right, shall we go?
Mr. President, have a public hearing, please.
Yes, we'll now public hearing on ordinance number 2012-198. Anyone in the public who would like to speak in favor or opposition to this paper?
Silver Persinger would like to express his support of this paper.
Thank you.
Mr. Persinger, is there any reason why you didn't care to come to the mic on this one to express your opinion?
To save time, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Okay, Madam Chair, at this time, I'll bring the paper back to the committee for discussion.
Discussion on action, please, of the committee.
Move for recommendation.
Thank you, Mr. Sanders.
Second.
All right, we have a motion to make a recommendation to council approving this paper. All those in support, say aye.
Aye.
Opposition? Okay, Mr. Clerk, please do vote. Let's go next paper. Number seven, let's go to number seven.
Item number seven, ordinance number 2012-207, to authorize the CAO to accept $59,671 from the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency and to appropriate the increase to fiscal year 2012-2013 stormwater utility budget for the purpose of forming a watershed coalition in the Bellamy watershed to the Bellamy watershed concept plan to restore the creek adjacent to the Oak Grove Elementary School.
Good afternoon, Michelle Burris with the Department of Public Utilities. This grant will allow us to facilitate a coalition over the next year so that the coalition can implement and prioritize projects in the watershed to make that healthy, walkable watershed that we intend to make.
Fabulous project. Excellent. Thank you so much for the work that you've been doing to make that a reality in this neighborhood and combined with the school. Great job. Any questions for the presenter? All right, Mr. Clerk, public hearing.
Okay, we will now have a public hearing on item number seven, ordinance number 2012-207. Is there anyone in the public who would like to speak in favor or in opposition to this paper?
Period of compliance to to recognize approximately $230,000 on that investment. This $1.5 million is patient capital and will remain in the project as long as RRHJ takes its option of right of first refusal and owns the project. If this project is ever sold, transferred out of RRHJ, then the city of Richland's loan will be repaid in full. With that, I'll answer the question.
Questions? Ms. Roscoe, I got this. This is for phase one, correct?
This is phase two. This is the next phase that's coming online in the first part of 2013.
And these are for 48 affordable housing units?
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah, the phase two, what is the, I guess the question that I have in relationship to this is, what is the timeline, what is the necessity of the timeline as it relates to this one?
You mean in terms of having it adopted?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Right now, before the total capital stack and the financing package, including the equity investors, can be approved by HUD to make the project eligible, our appropriation and cooperation agreement needs to be in place. And it is our desire to have that in place by the next council. If the finance committee will recommend it to be approved, that will be approved at the next 26th meeting, and at which time we will have the documents executed so that they can be presented as part of the capital stack package to HUD.
What's the deadline for the presentation, for the application to HUD?
Now, the application is pending our approval. They want to have that application to HUD by the end of 11:30 of this month.
All right. I have not been briefed on this loan, and I'm not prepared to support this without briefing. Yes. However, I'm very sensitive to HUD's deadline, application deadline. Well, I'm somewhat sensitive to it. I don't really know if I would know exactly what's being presented for HUD. If I'm understanding phase two to be different from the phase that is currently under construction.
Correct.
So not under construction.
This one is not.
So we'll continue this paper. I would recommend, inasmuch that I have not been briefed on this, that I would like to continue this until I get a better briefing and understanding of what is going to be in phase two of this development. It's my recommendation that I just want to put out on the top. And any other questions, Mrs. Rossian?
Madam Chair, I hear that you have not been briefed on this. However, I also hear there's a time limit on this, there's time constraints. So I was wondering, instead of continuing it, whoever has questions about this could try and get some of them answered between now and Monday. We send it with no recommendation, just like we did the other paper. And if you're still uneasy about it Monday, then we continue it.
I appreciate that, Ms.
Rossian,
but I will say without any questionable doubt, I have been working with the administration and the housing authority on this development for over 3 years. And I find it extremely disturbing that there will be a request for a loan in the district on a project that has not, that I've not been briefed on. And if I am briefed between now and then, when we get into informal session, I will change my mind and I will let you know. But at the present time, I want the administration to know If we can go to a public hearing, Mr. Clerk. Thank you.
Yes, Madam Chair, we now have public hearing on item number 12, ordinance number 2012-220. Is there anyone in the public who would like to speak in favor or in opposition of this matter?
I would simply, Silver Person, citizen of Richmond, Virginia, I would simply like to speak in opposition of continuing the paper. I suggest, well, I like Ms. Graziano's suggestion of forwarding with no recommendation, since there is time constraints, and I'm sorry on behalf of the administration for not updating you on this project, but, you know, $1.5 million, that's small potatoes compared to Redskins project. Please reconsider Graziano's suggestion. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Person. All right, the Grand Rapids Committee of Discussion.
Any discussion, not a recommendation.
All right, motion?
Move to forward to council without recommendation.
Second.
Second.
All right, call for the question. All those in support?
Aye.
Opposition?
I'm sorry, aye.
Opposition? All right, we're moving forward with the recommendation for, no recommendation. However, I would like to make sure that, that the committee is aware of the fact that, you know, we're not going to approve phase two of the project and funding for it without explanation of what that is. All right, Mr. Clerk, the next paper is number 14.
Madam Chair, item number 14, resolution number 2012-R145. To endorse and support the application of Anglewood Enterprises LLC for up to $262,500 in industrial access railroad track program funds from the Virginia Department of Rail and Public Transportation.
Good evening, members of the City Council. I'm Betty Antier. I'm with the Department of Economic and Community Development. And I'm here to just talk briefly about this resolution. This resolution is actually a requirement of a state application for rail access funding through the Department of Rail and Public Transportation. And it's a requirement to have our City Council support this resolution. The project is actually going to install an ethanol unloading facility with piping capabilities to transfer ethanol via pipeline to Kinder Morgan. And the company will invest about $1.75 million of that to our tax base. And I actually have representatives of the company here if you have any questions. Just one other question, one other point. It is $262,500 and there is no match requirement by the city. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Madam Chair, we'll now have a public hearing on item number 14, resolution number 2012-R145. Is there anyone from the public who would like to speak in favor or in opposition of this paper?
All right, we'll bring the next one to the
floor. Mr. Board, Council, move the recommendation for approval.
Second. Second.
support of this paper, but I think that it would be helpful before we move forward on it if we had some facts and figures that we could present as we moved along, because, I mean, although I'm much in support of this paper, I'm not sure what it would cost us short-term, long-term. I think those are facts and figures that we need to have.
As presented to the commission, is prepared to share the information.
Madam Chair, members of the committee, for the record, I'm Jim Hester, city assessor. I had previously submitted to you a report that outlined the number of exemption applications that had been presented for this year. The deadline for receiving applications for designation exemption was September 1st. So we have gathered together this list. It's on the back page of your report. The 16 applications, this is the maximum applications that we are allowed to consider for the coming year. Most of these appear to have been pre-qualified. However, that's still to be determined. We haven't moved beyond that step, that first step. And we have not scheduled public hearing that's required before this issue comes before council. Based on those 16 applications, the potential loss of taxable assessment is approximately $14.2 million. At the current tax rate, that would equate to approximately $170,000 in taxes this coming year.
Any questions?
Like to look at is because this report we've gotten from Mr. Hester But if we have $170,000 this year, and we have that for the next 5 years, that's $1 million. Or hasn't it?
No.
Close to it.
No, I guess.
Close to it. I'm just saying, we need to have a good handle on what it's costing us.
Currently, what is currently tax exempt? Do we know what the amount is for Sylvester?
I can get that number very readily to you.
Okay. All right, I mean, I know you've given us that number.
I have the AS too.
Yeah.
I've given this on different occasions, but I don't have it in front of me.
Personally, Manager, I'd like to wait till we get more information on this before moving it forward. I would like that one.
Well, the question is, we can continue the paper in committee another month. I don't know that, the challenge that we had this discussion, Mr. Hester, as it relates to how long do we want these applicants to be in a unknown status. But right now, the decision, and you know, the last time we went through this process, at the end of the day, the committee made one recommendation to us, and ultimately council almost completely overruled the committee's recommendation. And we were somewhat not absolutely confident that the review process and the information that council had based on the outcome of the recommendation were in question. We haven't addressed those issues. We certainly need to address, I think, need to have a discussion on addressing those issues prior to reviewing additional applications that are in the pipeline. I would not want us to go through a review committee and come back with the same kind of decision process, that lack of decision process, as we did the last time, that we should learn from that experience. So we can continue this for a month, but my question, Ms. Cross-Penalty, to Mr. Hester is, for those applications that are in process now that expect us to move forward with the review process. And Ms. Cross-Penalty, if you have a question related to that before you answer.
I actually don't have a question. I don't think that, personally, I think it would be in bad faith to accept applications for tax exemption and then halfway through that application process say, oh, by the way, we changed our minds, we're not going to do it. I don't think that this, I would like us to put a moratorium on it, but I don't see where we can make it effective prior to 2014. We already have people in the queue for 13.
Well, that certainly is an option that has been in good faith for those persons who have gone through the expense and time to put an application process in place, to submit an application. The expected review cycle that these applicants would be expecting, Mr. Hester, is what?
By ordinance, the applications are supposed to be reviewed and approved or disapproved by the city attorney's office by December 1st.
Yeah.
And then we start the public hearing process as early in the tax year 2013, in this case, as we can. Any decisions that are made beyond that point are just made retroactive to January 1.
Right.
No.
Yeah, what I would like, Mr.
Paul,
what I would like to suggest, in as much that, and I agree with, and we've had this discussion as it relates to good faith effort on behalf of the city. I think it's most of not, unless there's due to an absolute lack of funding or something of that nature, in this case that doesn't apply. It might be a lack of funding, but it doesn't apply because of the way that the, how this money is determined to be relief. That perhaps we will amend and continue this paper, making it effective so that we will post the attorney's office that as a patron of the paper, that we will amend this paper to close the application process. That means that we would consider those that are already in the pipeline, or we would close it to any future application acceptance. So we need to pass this paper so that we can close that window with that amendment.
The ordinance also includes the opportunity for the property owner to include personal property at their request.
So we can, I would like to offer a recommendation to the committee that we amend the paper to eliminate both those who put the moratorium in with the understanding that we will proceed with the review of those that are in the pipeline at the present time. If that's confusing enough, then.
Madam Chair, do we have to make a motion to do so today, or is that something that can be done offline by putting in an amendment?
I would recommend that we continue this paper for the request of that amendment to be considered back. I would like to put in a request from the attorney's office to start working on that amendment.
At the appropriate time, I'll be happy to second that.
All right, that's the motion.
Motion to continue this paper, Mr. Simon.
Aye.
Mr. Thomas.
one